Hello, hello, and welcome to Vidszor's cooking show. Today I'm gonna cook and show you how to cook in a bouteille de merde from Argentinian slugs. I originally wanted to have my representative fly to this tropical island of desolate desert, but they recently passed a law against the ownership of firearms, so unfortunately she couldn't come. Also, they initially offered us a ride for 6 people only, but that vaguely sounded like an attempted murder from that one movie, so we politely declined. Now then, today's crew of chefs is as follows. I will introduce them as they take up work. First, Chef Myrtle enters the stage. Her specialty is team organization and dishes from apples. As you can see, she is quite adept at organizing the workplace for everyone right off the bat. Next ones are Chef Texas, whose specialty is Japanese confectionery, and Chef Bagpipe, a pro at making Swiss cheese. And Chef Texas immediately summons a rain of poke from the sky. Very professional. Ignores the stray dogs. That'll be the next episode's dish. Now Chef Tilopsis, specializing in sugary drinks and energy drinks. She'll be on mountain duty today. The slugs are starting to show up, and Chef Bagpipe proceeds to skewer and pickle them with graceful movements of her hips. I mean the spear. I've always meant to say the spear. And now the star of the show, Chef Magellan. Specialty freeze drying and crimes against nature. And there it is. The first one of her unique cooking tools. Self-patented D-30 micro-missile warheads. Declared a war crime in 42 countries a few hours after its patent. Applause for modern tools. Next, Chef Torms arrives, master of both making seafood and synthesizing cyanide. The second warhead gets deployed, and oven is sure to be hot soon. Ah, it looks like Chef Magellan is getting excited too. Maybe she knows something that we don't. And there they are. The African-American Indian Austrian spitting yellow slug. Applause for internationality. Looks like they're a bit much for Chef Bagpipe, but that is fine. The warheads will quickly turn them into a nice uniform paste for our bouteille de merde. Meanwhile, Chef Torm has started preparing the rare spider fugu, also known as morceau de merde. However, despite its name, it's not the main ingredient for our dish. But not to worry, they've quite an explosive taste in their own right. Oh, it looks like the next participant is Stoic Chef Silver, whose specialty is murder. That's not to say he's a butcher, he just likes to kill animals. And after him, Chef Lapland, who is a butcher, with her specialty being the dismemberment of morceau de merde spiders. And she is also Chef Texas's gay girlfriend. Applause for inclusivity. And it looks like Chef Silver is ready to turn everything into ash with the help of the ever-present warheads. Chef Texas goes back to kitchen to cycle the workload between staff. Very efficient of her. Ah, and a metal crab. That will go into 3 episodes after this one. So hopefully Chef Torm can carefully prepare it. And now, Chef enters, with her specialty being these very slugs. She's so good at preparing them, in fact. Sometimes I wonder if she knows this so well because she's also a slug. Ah, beautiful. His lust for blood fulfilled, Chef Silver goes back. Another warhead. And another activation. Ah, these slugs are really good at damaging the machinery, but it's a good thing we have more of those at our warehouse. Chef Lapland exquisitely declaws the spider with a single strike, and Chef Thorns remembers he brought cyanide and starts blasting, though between us, he never really remembers it until the second time. Ah, such weak memory. Meanwhile, Chef Ayaya Ayaya quickly disposes of all the slugs as well as 2 spiders. just in time to not get violently murdered. Applause for perfectly calculated timing. Oh, it looks like Chef Magellan is working on two fronts now. Truly what they call a massive brain move on the internet. And Chef Spectre enters the fray. Her specialty is being sharpness testing and making pizza. As you can see, the dogs are pretty sharp objects, but she won't go down that easily. Oh no, what's this? The delicacy known as African-American Indian Austrian spitting red slug showed up. These are extremely dangerous, as they are known to be attracted to adopted people, therefore letting those people know that they're indeed adopted. However, as long as nobody on the team is adopted, this should be very easy. And now, Chef Texas comes back to deliver more delicious poke to the team. And as the slugs have damaged most of Chef Magellan's equipment, Chef Silver comes back in to indulge in the sweet slaughter that's currently going on. Thank you, Texas. Very cool. Chef Spectre retreats in light of her imminent demise, and Chef Bagpipe comes back in to pick off some of the slugs that the micro missiles couldn't kill, and she is instantly dead. What a moron. Applause for innocent death. And now Chef Saria comes in, specialty being a meat shield, as well as going to buy milk and never coming back. Just ask Chef Ifrit, whose specialty is barbecue, and who uses another unusual tool, a flamethrower, which was also extensively used by Nazi Germany in World War II, and has been outlawed for battlefield usage by convention of certain conventional weapons, Protocol 3 on incendiary weapons. Applause for historical trivia. While I was talking about that, Chef Torrance remember that he is indeed alive and got to work for real, along with Chef Silver, who is currently drinking blood of the slugs and may or may not be performing a satanic ritual. Chef Dilopsis has started force feeding Mountain due to other chefs, and Chef Saria has died, like she should, for abandoning such a violent child, instead of taking responsibility and killing and eating her. And there we have it. Our gourmet dish is ready. You may notice that the guest chef Suzerain had done nothing this entire time, which only proves superiority of our current staff over this useless slacker, and she'll be dealt with soon enough. And there we go, we've successfully made 14 servings of bouteille de merde, and these delicacies will be given away to the first 14 people to comment under this episode. All you have to do to be eligible is to tell us what your favorite dish is, and maybe we'll even cook it in one of our next episodes. So, thank you for watching, like the video and subscribe to the channel for more cooking, yes, cooking videos. See you in the next one.